Okay, so I went ahead and I did my stitch all the way around. Now I'm going to take this piece of fabric that I have laying around here, and I'm going to apply some to the back of my little heart here. Now this little pillow heart, you can stuff it into your little pocket. Remember I said we were going to do an assortment of little things to add to our little pillow. And again, this is a want to scrap album that you can create using laces, fabrics, and beautiful things. And you can do these, even though they're chipboard, you can use all the elements that you're used to using when you create shabby chic fabric albums. So we are going to, isn't that cute? I'm gonna trim this out if I can find my scissors in this massive mess I have in my desk. Don't normally have a mess in my desk, lady, but when you're crafting, it's kind of hard to prevent these kind of things. All right, so we're just going to snip around. You know, one of the things that you can do and start doing is when you have these little tiny scraps, if you plan to do babbles or babbles, sorry, you can save these little scraps and throw them into your Christmas babbles, and that gives you something to insert there. So I'm gonna go ahead and save that. That was just a little piece of scrap that I had. Now I'm gonna go ahead and grab my little Chinese braid here, and I'm going to start collecting that. That is one of my things for this year, is to save the little scraps for the babbles. All right, so then I'm going to turn it around, and we're just going to clean our edges because you guys know how I am about cleaning edges, and I love this little Chinese braid. Now you can get this kind of braid from Creating with Details as well. She's got an assortment of these, and I understand she's going to Spain and she will be bringing in a huge selection of them as well. So we're going to just go around here, go around those edges, and these are perfect little albums that you can create using scraps and other elements that you have laying around in your craft room. Feels like it wants to rain here, but it's not sure what it wants to do. But it was a really nice day. We went out to lunch and we had some other appointments we had to do. So we took care of that today. Again, I'm using my little adhesives. Should get to the Dollar Tree, but you know, in the meantime, if you don't have, use those little recyclable things. And then we have that little heart, and I'm just going to take some of my seam binding. And I do apologize, I can't bend my finger very well. Oh, see. Don't have really a lot of movement in that hand, so I do apologize for that. All right, I think that should do. So, this is my Deco Fun bow maker. We're just going to make a small little bow. home too, and then we're gonna add some little frilly stuff because you know we're girls and we gotta have some of this frizzy stuff. And this is that eyelash trim. Lift that up and kind of for some days I don't have too much movement in that hand. Alright. Lift that up. And I like my bows, as you guys know. I like them crazy. I like them funky. So there's really no rhyme or reason behind my bows. So no rhyme or reason behind them. All right. So we're going to attach that there, fold them over. And you can add a little picture of a loved one there if you want it in the back or whatever. I'm just going to add a little button. Simplicity sometimes is cute. So we have that going on. Like I said, I can see you. Then the light comes in and then you guys can't see. Alright, so we have that one going on. And then we have, this is the pocket, the one that we did yesterday. So we're going to tuck that little puffy heart in there. With all the added treasures that you can get. And then on this one, we did it yesterday. And what I wanted to do is add one of the Velcro's pieces to it. So we're going to go ahead and do that. So let me remove some of this here. Turn inside out, sorry. Save that. Let's glue this down because I didn't do that right yesterday. Let's glue that down. Ow. Said if I had to design, if I was good at graphic, I would have designed the where the score lines were a little bit wider, because if you're trying to glue down with hot glue, it's kind of rough. Alright, oh, we got it. Make sure we got that glued down. And we're going to add this little Velcro piece here. Press down hard on that. Peel that back. And that can go like that. And that way you can open and shut that, and you can make a little pocket. See how easy that was to make? Okay. An accessible pocket. or envelope, whatever. It's designed for paper crafting, but you know, who said it had to be for paper crafting, right? I'm gonna add a little button. You can find one. And we're probably gonna add some stick pins in this little album. We're gonna add all kinds of little neat things here. Let's put this away. All right. Put it where I can find it, because I know I'm going to be making more pockets. All right, so then in our little album, we have this little pocket. And we have this little thing here, and I added a little, like a tag holder. You can add a little picture, insert a little picture right in there. And then you have this here, and you can also insert a little picture of your loved one there. Tuck that into your album like so. And then again, you can add a little picture there of your loved one, a little pillow. And then here, see, for instance, you were doing an album for your baby. You can add his little teeth or one of your kids. You can add their teeth in here as a little safekeeping place for their little teeth. Wouldn't that be cute? I know I save some of my kids' teeth. So, or your umbilical cord, whichever. Or if you went on a date with your husband and you're making this for your hubby, you can add the first movie tickets, whatever, in there. Tuck it in here, just like so. Oh. So it's our exploding pocket that we have. And then, of course, we have made sure that I did not seal in the hole where we're going to attach things to. So that is that page, right? So then, of course, we made this little one here, and that's going to be for our next page. And I have this here, and I'm going to incorporate some of this here, just like so. So I'm just going to cut a strip of it, not too much. And we're just using, like I said, we're using scraps of things that we have laying around. And I'm definitely using a lot of the little scraps that I've had laying around from last year to design this album. Of course, I will put some little newer things in there, but we're going to design with whatever we have. So I'm going to glue that one down. Grab my little pink. Finger here. That adhesive, clean up some of this glue web. Okay. So then what I had thought about doing is I have all these little scraps. Oops, I lost that one. Of laces. Now this one. That would look cute around there, so we're going to add that. And start at the bottom though. I did have this one as well. Let's see something. Hold on, because I had planned this one here. And this one. Oh yeah, we're going to go that way. So we're going to go as I had originally planned with this other one here that I had left over from Holy Bejesus. This was from one of my kits when I had the store. All right, so we're going to pleat this starting at the bottom. One on top of the other. kind of a pleating style. And I like this trim because it enables you to be able to pleat in an easier way, even though it's a beautiful Venice trim. You can really pleat it really nicely. So, I'm going to pleat this.
Alright, we're home.
Just like so. And just go around. We'll be back. We'll go around entirely and I'll be back. Okay, so we've gone around and here up on the top, I trimmed it off and started again so that I didn't have too much of a balkiness there. And now we're getting down here to the bottom. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a bit of glue here. And the good thing about this trim, it's really easy and pliable so that you can move it around. So we're gonna pleat it there and there. Give it like a little bit of a twisty feel there. And then that is one layer. Then I have this one here. I'm thinking about using this one. I think this is, I don't know. I don't know where I got this from, to be honest. I think it's a Joann's trim. But I do need to pleat it here and there. So we're going to pleat, because you guys know me, in layers. All right. So again, we're going to do an entire layer, and we're pleating. Because even though this is a ruffled trim, it doesn't have the necessary pleats for me to do what I really want to do, especially when you're going around the curves and edges. And since it is a heart, it does have the curves, so keep that in mind. So we're just going to do small little pleats here and there. Now, sometimes I get my needle out and I give it a quick little running stitch. Did not feel like doing that right now.
Yeah, I paid it.
All right, so we have the second layer added on. Now we're going to take this trim here, which is a Hobby Lobby trim. And you guys have seen me guys use this one in several of my projects, and I highly recommend you use your little gadget for this one, because you're gonna have to kind of pleat it a little, because once you get up here in the curvy sections, it's kind of hard. So you're gonna have to maybe do it in smaller sections. Not too much pleating, but maybe enough. That's where your little handy dandy tool will come in handy. So you can kind of somewhat gather it in, especially around these little curvy areas. So, around there. And All right, so I went ahead and I pleated this Hobby Lobby trim all the way around, and then I took the Chinese braid and I did another layer. Now, of course, I have this little scrap here, and it's from Creating with Details. Kind of losing my voice here, ladies. And I'm just gonna apply that on top, just like so. Here and there. And I'm gonna go ahead and trim this little extra piece here. Now we're gonna continue this Friday night, and we will try to do another page together. I'm gonna try to do it slowly so that we can get these pages knocked out and not rush through them or feel that I'm being rushed. So we're just gonna take our sweet little time and craft and enjoy each other's company. All right, so we have that. There you go. Now, clean our little glue webs because we don't want those here. Now, there is this beautiful frame from Want to Scrap, and my idea behind it is to, I would like to get a piece of fabric, and I'm going to go through my little scrap pile and see if I can find a piece of fabric I can use to apply that on there. See what we find, See, this one's too see-through, too much. So what I might have to do, let's see, how's that gonna look? Let's take some of this and I'm just using my cheapskin chalk paint. Actually use my fingers right on it. I know, grody, right? But by the time I get up and look for my paintbrushes, which I do not see them nearby, I'm just gonna distress it a little, hide a little bit of the chipboard color, because we don't want that to show up. And we're just gonna work around this. And we can go on the outside, try to get these edges in, and then we'll use some keep some paper towel nearby. Now we're going to use an ink and distress it just a little bit. Distress this frame a little, because then we're going to go and take and cover it up with some of the Vintage Photo Distress Ink from Tim Holtz. And you can take and leave it just like this and use it right onto your picture, whichever you want, or you can put some Mod Podge and glitter and do it that way as well. And I like that. I really like that vintage distressed look. Make it like a really old frame. Another idea that you can do, and I'm liking it just like that in that raw. You can take some fabric. Let me grab my napkin here. You can take some fabric and glue it down and then just trim around. Like if you flip it down this way, once you glue it down, you can trim around those edges and you'll have a pretty, pretty frame. Now, what I'm going to do is I have this little image of this beautiful little girl, and we're going to place her just like so, and I'm going to trim around it. So I'm just going to take a pencil and just kind of lightly go around so that I know that is the inside circle of my frame. See? Now I'm just going to take my fabric scissors and just trim around. I'm going to leave a little bit of a edge there so I can glue that around. Okay. And then we're going to glue that right around those marks. Flip it. And we're just going to glue. And what we can do, you know what I'm going to do? Let's remove this backing. I forget to remove the backing sometimes, so I can apologize for that. So, again, let me align that. Oops. I'm just going to put a little bit, a couple dots of glue here and there. And get that frame aligned right around where those marks are. And then lift and glue. And then we'll have that beautiful frame in there. Minus any glue webs. Okay. So we're going to put that like that. And we can add some stuffing underneath to make that frame pop out a little bit more. And that's probably what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a piece of this felt. Going to glue down some that way it'll pop out a little. I'm sure Michelle's going to want me to do this anyway, so we're going to throw that in there. Yeah, fill it in. Let's move. can either spread it. Add some more. And we're going to trim these out. Thing is to make sure that that is not overlapping. There we go. Alright, so now we have that pretty little frame of the little girl, and that'll go. I'll push her down just a little bit down. Like so, and we'll probably add, let me do that centered, and just a little pretty applique, and let's see what else do we have. I'm trying to use what we have laying around, so if you see me going a little batty, I'm trying to work with what we have. So, nope, that won't work. where this one? I got this one from Michelle Francis, or Melissa Francis, sorry. Let's see if this will work. No, it's a new trim. Don't know where the beginning or the end is. We're just going to trim. Oh, that'll look cute. Yeah, we're going to use that. All right, so this is a cute little pom-pom trim that I picked up from Melissa Francis. And you can find her on Etsy. She's also on Facebook. Let's move this out of the way. Like I said, this is a new WannaScrap frame, and you can purchase it from WannaScrap.com, and it's under the new products. So stop on over there and check it out. And you can use paint, you can use sprays, you can use just about anything you want to make these frames pop out. Let's get this one better aligned. I'm such a stickler for things to be perfectly aligned. I think that's part of being OCD. Going on with the frame. Put that there. Put that there. And let's see what else we're gonna add. I like to add different elements. Nope, too much. Don't want to put that. Alright, so let's go ahead and glue this down. It's too puffy. We're going to glue that down. Press down on it so that it stays. There we go. And then we're going to add this one here. Okay, so we have that going on. Gives it a 3D dimensional pop there. And then we are going to put the word Valentine's. Maybe we can use this one here forever. That'd be cute. I'll use that there forever. Again, these are printed on straight on fabric. Okay, so now we have these little digital images, and I will make sure I link all the information below as to where I got them. Let me wash my hands. All right, ladies, so this is what I have figured out. All right, so we have this one layer that I've done here, and I'll bring all this goody stuff out. We've done all this glorious trims and laces, and I have this beautiful image, and I will link all these images that you can purchase on Etsy below. And here's one of the Ira La Mira, and I just basically glued it onto felt and did some edging on it. And here's this other image, and I got this beautiful doily from NSK Natasha Scrapbook Corner, and you can go to her Zibit store and check out all the beautiful stuff she has there. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and lay that down because I was already planning on what I wanted. So we're going to glue this down, and I realize that I'm going to go ahead and glue this one down, that this is going to be a huge project. So we're going to be carefully See that? Let's go this way. I need to make sure my hose are open so that we can. Gotta make sure those little holes are exposed. So I realize that this is going to be a huge project. So as I do little embellishments and things for this beautiful heart, I will do the videos. But tonight we're going to be on live. And I'm going to place that just like that. That's what I love about being able to work with fabrics, that you don't have to be so extremely precise or perfect when cutting. It's not like when you're doing paper that you have to be so precise, you know. And I love the fact that you can be not so precise when we're doing these kind of things. So here we're going to probably build some flowers. And then I got this little beautiful ribbon trim from Natasha NSK, and here is one of her seam bindings also that I picked up from her shop, and I'm just going to use some of these. I got about 50 yards of it, so we're going to crinkle this up and we're going to run it through. Let me see, I don't have too much. That finger is just, it's gone bad, ladies. All right, I'm not gonna lie. So we're gonna run it through. Make sure we have the right side. And what I love about this is that you can run your seam binding or ribbon right through, and it gives it a really cute flared look. What I typically, you know what? This is what I do. I'm going to braid it. Let's see if I can get some equal amounts here. Because when you braid, you tend to lose. So let's braid this. I'm going to be a little bit boho crazy here. And I'm just going to quickly braid this. Been smart, I would have taped it down, but I don't know where my tape is. I think I put it downstairs, but anyway, we'll braid it really quick. Doesn't have to be perfect because I'm funky like that, and you guys know that. And that's what makes it a tattered, funky album, when you're not being so stinking precise, right? All right, so we're gonna braid this, and then we're going to run it through our ribbon trim that I purchased from Natasha NSK Scrapbook Corner, and she's on Zipit, and you can go there and check her out and check all of the gorgeous stuff she has as well. So we're going to braid it all the way down to the bottom. And I know I'm going to have some extra piece, but that's okay because I love things to be cockeyed and crooked and frilly and funky. And it just gives it that really nice, unique look where it's not so precise and, you know. So that's what makes it fun, when you can just throw it together. It's like taking a paintbrush and throwing paint into a canvas and just going crazy with it. And not worrying about whether or not, you know, it's precise. So we're going to run that. Now I'm going to tie it to end. And we're going to take our little ribbon. And we're going to go in and out. Go in. Run it all the way through. All right. way through, just like that, and we're going to weave it in and out. Well, it gives it a really neat, unique flair to it, where you're not really, not one project is all going to look the same. You know, you got that uniqueness, that flair. Alright. And I'll keep doing this until we get to the end. It out here, and then that's gonna go like that there. Isn't that cute? And I'll show you what that looks like. It looks like little rosebuds coming out from that trim. So we'll trim it there. And then we have that. So let's see what else we'll put on here, because you know we have to give it that nice flare it. Nope, we don't want that. I'm just going in, selecting things that I have here. Nope, we'll use that for something else. Let's see how much of this I have. Now we'll use that for something else. So it's just a matter of selecting the scraps that you have laying around. All right, you have this. That's cute. Oh yeah, we'll put it on this corner. And that's just left over from another project. See how cool it is to be able to clean up some of these things? So we have that there. Make sure I am out of focus. This camera, I don't know what my family's done with, but it is not focusing right. Make sure we can see that beautiful image. So we need to trim maybe a little bit there so it's not covering up the little beautiful image. This we can throw in there. That is from another project. I think that was from my Santa's, if I'm not mistaken. Nope, too much of that. We don't want too much of something. We have that there, and that's from That is from Creating with Details, and we have another one we're going to add there. And what do we have that it's a scrap? See, I like that there, so we'll probably put that there. That's a scrap to something. And Before I even do anything, I like to make sure that's what I want. And again, we're just having fun. And I like that, so we're going to go with that. We're just having fun throwing things on this album that our leftovers aren't, you know, Sometimes we disregard these little leftover pieces that we've had left over, and I want to be able to use them. Got a little bit left over for something else. So that way you want to be able to use them. So we have that, and let's see what else I can figure out. Instead of that, I also have this one. This one's cute. Let's see. Not much of a piece. I like that one, so we're going to go with that one. We're going to go with that. No. Keep putting that one aside. No, I kind of like this one. Sorry. Yeah, I like that one. To say, it gives it that funkiness to it that I always look for. And that is what I like. Funky, funky. But we wanted this, so we are not going to do that, right? We're going to go with this one because it looks like... Let me bring it up to you. Isn't that pretty? And then here, what I'm going to do is probably not... put the glue entirely around. I'm probably going to go down and make a little pocket insert. So we're going to go to town and just kind of glue it down here. Leave that pocket there, and we can probably finish that edge. Let's finish that edge. Can go there. But I don't want to do that. So we got that pocket. Now we're going to do this pocket here. So that way you have that insert there. And we can certainly shut down just a little so it doesn't fall out. So now we just have this pocket right there. So you can tuck something in there carefully. All right. Let's get my little... I need to go to Dollar Tree and get one of those lint rollers. But right now we recycle these little pieces. All right, so now we have that. And then we have this beautiful little trim we just did. And again, I like the flareness of it being hanging out from the side. So we're going to go right smack on top of here. This is about not worrying about the perfection of it, but creating something that it's different and unique, and you know, you're not having to worry about, is it precise? Is it aligned right? You know, it's just funky. So now we have a little pocket in there, almost like a little balcony. We can tuck something in. Now we have these little pretty flowers from Creating with Details. And I have been having problems with my wire cutter. I do need to get a new wire cutter. I thought I had my wire cutter here. I don't see it. I don't know where it went. So we're just going to use these old snippers, which you should not do that. Do not do that. All right, so we're gonna put a little bit of a floral here, and you can find these at Creating with Details store. And align it how you want, and I have three. I always like trying to do things in threes. We're gonna put that there. on as far as my top. Let's see. Before I do that. Yep, we'll do that there. See, we're just using snippets here and there. So that's a little extra something. We just made a little frame. We can add little buttons down here on the side. A little cup here of buttons. And we're going to put that around there. And what else do we have laying around here? We have this little cute bow that we can tie our little flower in or on. And I did have a little word. I don't know where I went with it. But we did have a little word. All right, so we're going to go ahead and put our little bow on our flower spray. I'm going to put that there. Pop out our little flower. Let that go crazy hanging down. We have this little cute pocket that we've made, and we can probably tuck that in there, and you can probably put some pins or something in there, so that'll go in there like that. And then here, let's see, what do we put on there? Let me put a big old button. And let's see. I really need to clean out all this mess. That's what I really need to do, is clean out all my mess. Okay, so now we're just going to do our little random bow. I'm going to take some sari yarn, this lace, and this is just a piece of fabric that I cut into strips, and I grabbed this from Joann's. They no longer carry it, but I really love that. It was one of my favorite. It's like a mesh. I'm going to get our Deco Fun bow maker here. Not too big of a tail. And make sure they're pulled in tight. And wrap it around one more time. Make sure they're in tight so they're even. And I'm just going to snip down here and use this little meshy one. Lift up and go underneath. And tie. Lift up. And I don't mind these little shorter pieces. I actually like that. That's just how I am. Do not mind those. So then we're going to fluff this bow out. Move my little bow maker over. And see, I like that little snippet piece there. I don't know why. I just do. Makes it cute. that's gonna go down here, just like so. It also stops it from our little thing falling out. And on this, you would have to put a lot of glue. Lift up. Fluff out your bow if you need to. I hold it in place and try to fluff out. So that as it dries up, it stays put. I like the randomness of the funkiness of that bow. I'm going to put a little button there. And it does have the shank, but I'm just going to keep that shank right there. Alright. We have that going on. And I love it, love it. And let's see if we can get a little word or something. Did have one that said love, but I can't find it now. Well, when I find it, we will put a little message up here. Maybe a little deeper. Sometimes if you look deeper, you might find it. Maybe I can put, let's put this little heart there. Let's put a little heart there. Let's put this one maybe. It's kind of bare. It needs a heart. It needs a heart, ladies. Let's put those there. So I'm going to get my felt, and we're going to put these on felt, pull out the backing. Down. We're going to go in, get closer in. And then we'll cut. And remember, leave all these little scraps because they're useful for other things. and I'm going to fray this out because I want it to be more frayed out. And we can probably, so let's do that.
Mommy.
And let's do a tartan, and I'm going to take a needle and sew. I can get in there. Sometimes with the glue, it's kind of hard. Just kind of sew in there. A heart, a little button into my heart. Let's set it there. So then we have this little heart to tuck in here. And where's my little one? And then we're going to put this little one in there. Alright, so we're going to attach these two little hearts here because it gives it a really cute accent to this little heart here. The baby heart. It'll go right there as well. So that just gives that page a beautiful look. And then tonight we're going to work on the pocket side of it. And we will talk about some of the things that I did for this page. Okay, so we'll see you tonight. Alright, so this is a trim I picked up at Joann's and I did a little bit of a coffee dye on, and I'm just going to go ahead and start applying in the back of this here and on these because it is a Venice lace with little hearts and stuff like that, like little petals. I'm going to do each little flower piece individually, gluing it down. I know I said that I was going to do this part live with you guys, but we really have 5 pages and we need to move along because I have so many projects for Wanna Scraps that I want to share with you guys. So we're going to try to knock this one off before tonight, and then I will just show you guys what I did, and then you guys can see the videos on how I did it. Hopefully that all works out. All right. Carefully go around these little edges, and sometimes it's kind of hard with the edges. You have to kind of pleat them around. So on some of these, because of the shape of the heart and the angles, you have to sort of double pleat it, you know what I mean? Or maybe miter, wherever you can. I have a busy weekend, ladies, and I said that I'm going to try to have some painting done in my home. That's why it's easier if we just do each little individual daisy and just kind of curl it around. Sometimes taking your time is the best solution for things like this. But on this side, I think I'm going to probably give it a swirl with some of their chipboard. Wanna Scrap has some fabulous chipboard words. So we're going to try to play around with some chipboard words, and we're gonna pop out our paint. So definitely need some chipboard words, that is for sure. I hear my daughters come home from school, and I have several little things that I need to do. It's gonna be a busy weekend for me. It's probably gonna be one of those all-nighters because I want to scrap album to class tonight, and then I have creating the details. I gotta work on a kit. So I'm gonna be quite busy, and I also want to paint my living room. It needs it, ladies, it needs it. So we're gonna do that, and then we're gonna kind of miter right there. And what I mean miter is kind of twist and turn there wherever we can and just give it a cute little finished touch right there. Alright, there we go. So we have that, and now we have that going on that side of our album. Let me pull it out a bit lower. I know, I'm crazy, right? But it does work on this, so thanks to the person that gave me that suggestion. That was an awesome suggestion. Alright. I try to save all the adhesive papers from the backing of my fabric adhesives sheets and use those as a recycled means. Alright, so now we have that. And so what I was thinking for our pockets, because you know we have to have some type of a pocket. I have this here crocheted piece, and I'm looking around as to what other things that I pulled out over the Christmas holidays that I wanted to clear out. But I definitely need to clear out some of this stuff. We're gonna work with these because I coffee dyed that before the holidays and didn't use it. And let's see, we got this one here. Let's put this one here. So the purpose of this one is we're going to do a pocket on this one. And let's see what else we have. We have this one too. That one's pretty. Pulling out all this stuff, all the stunts of all the stuff I have. And I like to do... I might not need that pocket, that one there. That way we can show some of that beautiful fabric there. So maybe we can do that with, let's see, this one. I haven't used this one very much. There's a second layer there, so let's try that one there. This way. And then let's see what else do we tuck in here. We kind of need a little bit of a assistance there on that pocket. So let me see what else I pull out of these magic drawers that we have in here. My daughter was organizing some of this, so it's hard to tell what I have and what I don't have. So let's see, kind of like that. Don't like that one there. Don't like that one there at all. I really like that one. We can go that way. And maybe that one's too short. I love this one. That one is for sure a keeper. So I'm just trying to play around. I got this one from somebody and I really don't like the how frizzy that is. This is another gorgeous piece. See, I love the way that one stands out. So I want to definitely use that one as one of my pockets. And like I said, the pockets, they don't have to be necessarily like straightforward like that, you know? I like kind of angle that out. And I like that, so we're going to go with that. So let's trim here. Let's save that for another pocket maybe. Yeah, I think we're going to go this way. I know, you guys are probably thinking, May, you're cutting out, but this we can use on a picture or something. And I'll make sure we use it, ladies, I promise. There. So we're going to go this way. Yeah, I like that better. I don't want to cover up too much of the shape of the heart, so let's go for that. And again, we are not, we don't want to seal down the pocket, so we're just going to go where we can have the pocket free. Wherever those pockets can be free. And I'm trying to hit in around the embroidered pieces of this here. Now we don't need the pockets to go all the way down, so we will go halfway down here because we definitely don't need and right here. That way the pocket is free here, and we can insert pictures, memorabilia, mementos, whatever you have that you want to put in here. Let's make sure we get all these in. And again, make sure your pocket is functional. So that is that layer. Now when you're doing your second layer, again, you have to make sure you're not closing out. So if you want to insert a piece of an acetate, this is perfect because it won't glue down. That way you can get those areas perfectly glued down with no problem. This one can go on there. And again, make sure you don't glue down your pocket when you're doing this. It's very important, otherwise you defeated the purpose, right? just kind of going in here and there and gluing where it needs to be glued down. And I'm making sure this whole time that my pocket is available for me to insert pictures or memorabilia along there. So that works. I'll remove that out. We have that going on. And let's see, we have enough of this. We don't, but we'll leave it for another project. And we have this cute little piece here from Melissa Francis. I think that would be cute there, don't you think? What do you think? Maybe, maybe not? Nah. Another piece for something else. All right. Let's see, I have this. I'll have that there. I know, you guys are thinking, man, you put too many layers of stuff. But that's what gives it that cuteness. You know? I think this is an Amy Love trim. I do like this, but it covers up that, so we're going to save that for something prettier. And I did like this here, so we're going to go with that. Let's see what my other options are. Again, we're going through and selecting trims that we have laying in here. Save that for something else too. See how I am? My brain doesn't ever stop. Let's see, we have this one. It's a small scrap of previous kit. That one's cute. Again, the whole thing about Shabby Chic is all the massive layers that you can put in to make that album unique. And I always like to lift up and look. I don't like the way that combination goes, so we will swap that out for something else. We have this. We can leave that there for an image. Let's see. If I put this in here, I think that gives it a cute, unique look. Let's see. Let's see, ladies. That. Let's go down on that one. I have that. Oh yeah, I love that combination. See, that's a cute little combination. So that's what you have to play around and figure out how you want this placed. So I love that combination and we're going to go with it. And I went about probably about 3/8 of an inch down from the top layer. And we're going to go with this one. Okay. I'm going to trim it off here. Use that for something else. So we'll throw it heel. And then we're gonna go with this one. Making sure we have it on the right side, and we're just gonna go right smack on that border because I like that scallop edge. And I'm holding it up because I don't want it to stick down. Safekeeping. It doesn't glue down my pocket. All right, so then we have that. Let me get my little finger. Down, double check. Make sure your pocket's not being glued down. If you do have that problem, take out your undo and just undo it. All right, now we have that little piece for something else. Pop that there. Then we have this one here. And we're going to go right smack, leaving that scallop in. Again, I still have my acetate sheet down there. And I'm being very careful. I do not block or close my pocket. Double check, making sure you do not seal your pocket. I love it when my kids come home from school. I hear all their little stories and I'm missing it. I'm up here. All right. So we're just going to glue that one down. Again, glue down that pocket on the side. Making sure nothing is glued down too much. Out and pocket is done. Here we go. Isn't that gorgeous? Beautiful pocket. Okay, so now I'm going to grab my lint roller again. Beautiful idea. I think it was Crafty Moo that told me about the lint roller. So thank you, Crafty Moo. Alright, so we got that going on. Again, we have to make sure we do not seal around the pocket there. Of course, this was here. That went there. Now let's get an image. And all these here, you can add pictures of your loved ones onto them. And I got another envelope that we need to work on. So let's work on this envelope. And this is from Ida La Mira, and you can definitely go to her site. I will make sure I will put the link in. So you can go down there and purchase the image and print them on fabric. And you have yourself a fabric pocket or envelope. Does have some little words on it, so I'm going to trim those off while I'm at it. And it does, see that. I was trying to see any quotes, any Valentine's quotes that were laying around. I couldn't find any that I could use. All right, so we're trimming these off, and then I'm going to use some florals and some other things from chipboards from one of Scrap's collection. And again, don't forget to use your May Saves Me 40 coupon code to get 40% off your purchase. All right. Get all out of the way, and we will rock it out. Oops, I didn't want to do that. This is definitely a must have. Look at that. I can pick up all my glue webs really quick. Must have in your craft room now. All right, so here's my little pocket, and I did go over a little over here from where the original cutoff is for the pocket because it'll make it easier. This is about a quarter inch, and I want it a little bit bigger. Take your bone folder, and you don't have to necessarily use a bone folder. This is actually a carving knife or clay. So I'm going to just score around where you have to fold. And when you skit these, you'll see it says glue. So it's going to give you a really good indication as to where you need to fold. Then once you have that pretty much set out, and you can also use your nails. That's another way of doing it.